Hi there, Sirdar here for InfoWorld at IDG. Today in SmartPython, we're going to explore Python's disassembler, a tool for examining the bytecode of Python programs in detail, which can give you a better idea of what Python does under the hood when it runs your applications. Okay, so what is bytecode? Well, when you create a Python program and feed it to the Python runtime, it isn't run as is. It's translated into a series of low-level instructions used by the interpreter, and those instructions are typically saved in a binary format so they can be reused later. These instructions aren't the machine language used by the CPU, though. They're instructions specifically written to drive Python's runtime. Python includes a module, dis, that lets you interactively dump bytecode and examine it. Now, this isn't limited to bytecode from other programs, by the way. A program can dump its own bytecode. Here's an example for you. I have a function that does some trivial math. When I import the dis library, I can dump out a disassembly of the code in that function by just passing the function object to dis.dis, which is the disassemble method. In the disassembly, and we see here, the first column is the line number for the code that we're disassembling, so you can match the bytecode to its source. Second is the name of the instruction, also known as an opcode. If an opcode has arrows next to it, that means it's a jump target. It's a location in the code that the interpreter will jump to, such as within a loop. Third column is any values associated with the opcode, like names or constants. For instance, in the first line here, we're setting y to 1.0. This breaks down into two instructions, load constant, which sets up a constant value of 1.0, and store fast, which stores the last loaded value into a given name in the local namespace for the function. It's called store fast because we're storing it in a local variable, and local variables are faster than global ones. One of the reasons it can be useful to disassemble code is because the opcodes used in a code block can give you a better idea of what the interpreter is actually doing at runtime. Here's a simple example. In the first of these two functions, we're using local variables to build a string. In the second, we use globals. If we disassemble the code for both functions, you can see the calls reflect this behavior. In the first case, we're using load constant store fast, as we described before. In the second, we're using load global to get the variables, which is potentially a slower operation since it involves searching the namespace for the entire module. Insights like this aren't always available just by staring at your code as you've written it. Sometimes a disassembly is the best way to see it. One rule of thumb about disassemblies is, the fewer opcodes a given function uses, the more efficient it tends to be. But like any rule of thumb, this has exceptions. If something uses dedicated opcodes, as opposed to generic ones, that's usually a sign it's more efficient. For instance, here we have two ways of formatting a string, one using the format method, and another using fstrings. The format method involves a generic function call, the call method opcode. The fstring method uses dedicated opcodes, format value, and build string. And these end up being slightly faster, again, because they're dedicated to this specific job. Generic function calls require more overhead and more back and forth inside the interpreter, and so they tend to take longer. That's it for our quick introduction to Python's disassembler. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Smart Python, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.